Senator, turning the corner to another subject I know that you discuss frequently, and because there's been a lot of comment about this lately, and that is the big banks and what to do about them. It's been a central theme of your campaign. A number of people, though, experts like Barney Frank, who was part of the Dodd-Frank legislation that was passed after the Wall Street financial collapse, they are saying that the pledges, the speeches that you're making are ignoring what's already changed. And just 2 points. Number one, they say federal regulators already have the power to do what you're calling for, that they can seize, they can dissolve a bank that is taking too many risks and would be the ones to do so. And second, they say the protections that are now built into the system, including requiring banks to hold more assets, are working, that the system is not as risky as what you described.
Well, okay. First of all, Judy, it'd be useful to mention that Barney Frank is a strong supporter of Secretary Clinton, active in her campaign. Second of all, it would be important to point out that three out of the four largest banks in this country today are bigger than they were when we bailed them out because they were too big to fail. That you got the six largest banks in this country that have assets of 58% of our GDP. I happen to believe that when you have a few financial institutions with unbelievable economic power, with unbelievable financial power, that what we should do is reestablish a modern Glass-Steagall legislation, and what we should do, in fact, is break them up. Not only from a risk perspective of not seeing their greed and illegal behavior destroy our economy, as happened 8 years ago, but also from creating a competitive financial system where we don't have so few financial institutions with so much power. But those are some of the issues I am talking about in this campaign. And I think the reason we are doing so well is we are taking on very powerful special interests who are very protective of where they are today. We are asking, for example, why we are the only major country on earth that doesn't have paid family and medical leave, why we are the only major country that doesn't guarantee health care to all people through a national health care program like Medicare for All, why we have such a grotesque level of income and wealth inequality, while at the same time we have more children living in poverty than any other country. The reason we are doing well, Judy, is in fact we are taking on Wall Street. Unlike Secretary Clinton, I don't get millions of dollars for my super PAC. I don't have a super PAC from Wall Street, from the fossil fuel industry, from the drug companies. Now is the time, I think, in a critical moment in American history, for our people to come together and tell the billionaire class and tell Wall Street and tell their apologists that we do need a government that works for all of us, not just a handful of wealthy campaign contributors.